Almost 40% of our European Union's budget is spent on agriculture. To ensure that enough European food is cultivated in a sustainable way, consumers can buy European products at reasonable prices, and the average European farmer can earn a decent income. Artificial fertilizers play an indispensable role in making this plan work, maximizing the use of the less and less available European soil without exhausting it, and leaving unharmed what's left of European nature. One of the chemists that enabled the use of artificial fertilizers is Latvian Nobel Prize winner Wilhelm Ostwald. The Ostwald process he patented makes it possible to produce nitric acid, one of the key raw materials for artificial fertilizers. What makes a modern city do well? In short, organizing and reorganizing the available space. The how question, of course, is a lot more complicated, because you want to do what's good for all of your citizens, because you want all citizens to be proud of and loyal to their city, because they experience a fair balance in authority and justice, equal opportunities for entrepreneurs and customers, taking good care of social matters, health and support, and a sense of beauty. Because who wants to live and work in a junkyard? During his lifetime, Portuguese architect and professor Fernando Távora was highly involved in organizing and reorganizing space in the cities of Porto and Coimbra. Now, at the time of Clint Eastwood's Good, Bad and Ugly, you just needed a fingernail to light a match, which made smoking dangerous for more than one reason in those days. Fortunately, around 1844, Swedish professor and inventor Gustav Erik Posch came up with the brilliant idea to separate the phosphorus from the head of the match and put it on a specially prepared striking surface at the side of the box. For younger generations, Sladkat made a special instruction video on actually how to light the old-fashioned Swedish safety match. Sadly enough, not to everybody's benefit, as one comment said, "Instructions unclear, burned down my apartment and got arrested." Here, at the Bonafante Museum in Maastricht, Italian architect Aldo Rossi not only designed this outstanding museum landmark, the tower, but he also designed the great stairway leading to the heavenly ceiling inside the top of the tower. Well, be honest now, most of us just use their available garden space in the most efficient way. So we first place the garden table and then the lounge area. A bit more philosophical, you could consider your garden as your second living room. Today's garden centers are packed with ever more feel-good products to recreate the cozy atmosphere you experience indoors. Or you can choose to follow the ideas of Spanish landscape designer and philosopher Fernando Caruncho, where he says, "I want my brain to be stimulated in reflection and inquiry by following the light to delineate lines, perspectives, and symmetries." Yes, you can. You too.